first assignment in the class, there's sort of two major assignments you're going to have in the class. One is this, and then the other is going to be a bullshit case study toward the end of the class, which we'll talk more about. But this first one is to do what I call a bullshit inventory, which is just to get a sense, just reflect a little bit on the prevalence of bullshit in your own life. And so what I want you to do is find some mechanism of tracking the bullshit that you encounter in your own life. It could be you make a note on your phone. Could be you keep a piece of paper with you and write it down. It could be if you've got a really good memory that you sit down and reflect at the end of the day about all the bullshit you dealt with. But be aware of it. And that's going to be hard because the lists are going to get long. Be aware. So, you know, you want to think about a few things. I would suggest, I want a lot of creativity here, so you guys can really, you know, determine the parameters of the assignment. But I do want you to think about a few things. I want to think about all the bullshit that you want to think about all the bullshit you're fed. You're going to be fed a lot of bullshit. You know, hopefully not in here, but you'll be fed bullshit in various places. I want you to think about the bullshit that you create. I create bullshit, and I expect most people here do as well. And so keep note of that. Like, when am I bullshitting someone? When am I putting bullshit out there? And then I want you to think about the bullshit that you debunk. Like, when are you debunking bullshit? When are you trying? When do you think you've been successful? Right? So I bet there are people in this room that are trying to live their lives to be carbon neutral, right? Trying to make sure that your effect on the planet is carbon neutral. How many people in this room are bullshit neutral, right? So, you know, are you debunking as much bullshit as you're creating? I think that's really hard. Or are you at least bullshit average? Are you at least not creating more than you receive? I hope. So I would like you to try to keep track of this sort of thing. And you do that for a week. And then I want you to find a way to represent it as you see fit. And I'll talk a little bit about you know, the kinds of things we're looking for. But really, really open to creative ideas here. We just want you to do the assignment, think of some way of representing it. We're going to, you know, grade it based on the fact that you do it.
By turning it in, that's 10 points. Creativity is going to be a set of points. And comprehensiveness is just the level of detail. We know that you run into more bullshit than three or four things. So we want more than that. So not to prejudice you too much, but we do want to give you a couple examples of this carbon.
So here's one that I put together with the help of my daughter using some fake data because I didn't have time to actually do a full inventory. So I wanted to just do a sort of a Venn diagram kind of thing of bullshit that I encountered and bullshit that I created. So on the bullshit encountered side, we've got bullshit from my department chair. This is hypothetical, Toby. Okay. My department chair doesn't actually do this, but other department chairs might. Bullshit at work, bullshit with a left-wing agenda, bullshit that pissed me off, bullshit from my co-instructor, bullshit after 10 p.m., bullshit in all caps, bullshit while drinking a beer, bullshit that made me laugh, bullshit on the internet, bullshit that I created deliberately for this class. So that's on that side. And then bullshit that was created deliberately. And then bullshit that I created was, you know, well, I created some at my co-author's expense for this class. I was paid for some of it. Some of it went undetected. Some of it was in PowerPoint. Some of it was after midnight. Some was by accident. Some I later regretted. Some in rhyme. And some of which, for which I was punched. So that's kind of that would be one way to take a data set there. I've sort of chosen, you know, just for fun, I've chosen these sort of non-orthogonal axes on which to carve up the various kinds of bullshit in the world. And we just want you to be creative and find your own way of expressing. We really like these kind of lo-fi designs. You want to talk about this one?
Yeah, and so this is these are some of the designs. That's actually, this design idea came from Amanda Cox, who's one of the sort of experts in visualization at the New York Times. And so she sent us some examples on a data project. You'll see the link on Canvas if you want some other ideas. But here's the other cool thing. In addition to the discussions with Amy on Canvas, they're going to take some of the best examples from your inventories, from your BS inventories.
With your permission, of course.
Yeah.
But with your permission and with attribution if you want.
Yeah, exactly. So this Dear Data project, they sort of let people loose on the ways that they tracked a specific
Here they're looking at time. Here they're interested in how often, they're trying to record how often they become aware of the time. And so this is supposed to be a graphical illustration that somebody did on the back of a postcard, and I'll show you the front of the postcard in a second, of how often they checked the time over the course of the day. And so this may be the course of, you know, hours over the course of a week, right? And this is how often the time was being checked. And then there's like a little key here, you know, various reasons why they checked the time: on purpose, I just happened to glance at it because I thought of my time project. I thought, don't look, but I did, because I was bored, because I was hungry, et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, it's just an elegant way to, and then these attributes, right? I'm late. Okay, I'm fine, analog, et cetera. So, the idea is that we just want you to be creative. I love these lo-fi designs, as I said, but, you know, whatever you want to do, if you want to do something, interactive on the computer or whip something up in PowerPoint or whatever it is, we just want you to try that experiment of tracking bullshit that you're engaged with over the course of a week and then finding a fun way to represent it. And then people who want to have their designs considered for the New York Times article we'll make a way to make those available to Amy. And if you don't want, of course, there's absolutely no obligation.
In like 5 minutes, Carl and I came with three or four ways that we would do this. So I imagine you guys will come up with 3,000 or 4,000 different ways of doing that. So that's it for today. Thanks for paying attention. Next time we'll do a different topic. If you have questions, let us know.